Ah, the Cadbury's chocolates.
That was mine. I did taxidermy for a few years until the wife got sick of it, and I used to keep my stuff in that, yeah.
Is that for sale?
Yeah.
Yeah? You can pull it out?
Yeah.
Love it.
Go into the roof space storage and immediately you can't miss it. Great big Cadbury's chocolates countertop display. With the advertising on them, it just changes it completely, and they're way more desirable and valuable. What would you want for that?
It's got to be 100, isn't it?
It's worth a lot more.
In 1831, the first Cadbury's factory was opened in Birmingham, just 50 miles from Kevin's Steelworks. Cabinets like this one were used to display the chocolate bars on shop counters. Restored, this cabinet could have a value of £800.
I've got to be fair. £250.
Suit me down to the ground.
Thank you. It's amazing what you can find, a rare, interesting thing in completely unrestored condition. It's oak, it's got it all going on. Nice piece of history. The white top hat, no, it's not me. That is, though. It's a bit tatty, but...
It's got a couple of drawers missing.
Oh, has it?
On the bottom, yeah, the bottom.
Easy to make. Doddle. Hmm, interesting.
In the days when every customer was individually looked after by an attentive tailor, haberdashers' units like these were a common shop fitting. Restored, this one could be worth about £2,500.
This would have been something that you would have had socks, underpants and shirts, vests, ties, that type of thing really in there. But it's a good size, good colour, oak ones I prefer. How much is it? As it stands, just don't do anything, just as it is.
As it stands, I mean, I know it's a bit of work doing to it.
Needs a lot of work.
I know how much it's worth when it's done, but...
I've got, at the minute, about 30 of these in, all different shapes and sizes, and they're proving pretty popular for me at the moment.
So you might not want to give me much for it, then. Would you give me 800 quid for it?
No, not in this state. I'm at 6. If it was a bit tidy and it had the drawers, fine. Not bothered about the glass and the scratches and everything.
Do you reckon we could split it at 7? If I can fetch 7 for it, then, you know, I've got a bit of wage out of it.
Yeah. Yeah, not going to bother arguing with you. It's a big old unit, but it does need a lot of work. That's at the absolute top end of what I can pay. I couldn't pay a penny more for it, but we've got to help each other in this business. He needs to make a quid, so do I. I'm not going to begrudge him his profit.
My drummer's stool.
Is that what it is?
1950s drummer's stool, yeah. Tilts.
Have we gone?
Tilts. Oh, I see.
That's in case you get a drum with a short leg on one side.
Drummer's stool came from a little second-hand shop out on the coast. Was out on the beach one day and I nipped to a second-hand shop and found a drummer's stool, which is quite a quirky little thing.
Quite like it. I just don't like the red paint. And strangely, I don't like... See the way it doesn't line... That doesn't line up with that one.
This 1930s drummer's stool carries the maker's mark of Paragon. Tilting and height-adjustable, it's made of chrome with a cast-iron base and could be worth £200.
How much is it?
I've got 65 on it, but I'd let you go to 45 trade.
Yeah, it's cool enough. I can get that paint off the bottom of it. Yeah.
That's a rare old item.
Yeah, there's a couple of bits in here that I saw. The sex shop sign I like. And I did like it was that cross there.
I mean, that cross, I'd probably be looking about 1,200 quid for that. Sex shop neon, looking about 600 for that.
Neon gas powers these signs. It was first discovered in London in the 1890s, but it was at least a decade before it took off as a lighting source. It was first used in Paris in 1910 and got to America by 1923. With no restoration needed on the sign, Drew can sell it on exactly as he found it. It could be worth around £900.
Either really religious or really seedy signs sell very, very well. I bought and sold a sex shop sign not very long ago, only a few months ago. It sold the same day it went on the website, and I had several other people wanting it.
Looking at about 600 for that.
Is that all in VAT and everything?
Be plus the VAT.
Plus VAT. I was like quite happy at 500.
Plus the VAT, yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Deal. Marvellous, thank you very much. Bit of a giggle, isn't it? A bit naughty.
Yeah, he's seedy, isn't it?
It's not a new sideline you've got for Gav planned.
It's seedy. That's what yeah, it is. Yeah, we're going to hang that above the warehouse. Yeah. To be able to just walk in and buy a sign that is ready to go is much better for me. As time goes on, you know, we need to be buying things. There is no work to do because we have so much backed up restoration work that we just can't cope with it. Cool, right then, let's get the van. It's boiling in here and let's get that out of here. Excellent, love it.
We're saying we had the bench you saw in Outer Hall.
Yeah.
We used to have one either side of each other.
Right.
But the other one is over here, which is not in as good a condition.
God, yeah, it's in a terrible state, isn't it? Do you know where they came from?
No. Again, I could probably get a better idea for you because it was included in the valuation that was done 2011.
What did they value it at? I mean, it's in terrible, terrible condition. It's full of woodworm.
I think it was valued then at 700, but I know it's worth less than that now.
Hmm.
Simon believes this pitch pine bench pairs up with another in the castle hallway, which bears the family coat of arms, suggesting it could be more than 200 years old. In good condition, it could fetch around £2,500.
I'd like to see it go to a good home, to be honest.
Well, we can restore it and pass it on. £400?
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, there you go, that's 400. I've just kept my French polisher in business for another week. The good points about the bench are, one, it's the right price. It's a good restoration project. It's different as hell. I mean, you're not going to see many of these lying around. And it will appeal to the American market hugely.